Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Thursday, January 19th meeting of the City of Ojai Arts Commission. And we will ask the clerk to call the roll, please.
Commissioner Balderman?
Here.
Commissioner Golden?
Here.
Commissioner Conrad?
Here.
Vice Chair Harmon?
Here.
Chair Addison?
Here.
And Commissioner Byrne is absent.
We also have one vacancy on the commission, and my hope is that you will soon.
Sorry, there. All right, we will start with the Pledge of Allegiance. Commissioner Golden, would you lead us today, please?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Forget that.
They never should have changed.
No.
No, they shouldn't. It was a political gesture, and I don't subscribe to it. However,
oh my,
goes in this new era. We will now continue with public comment, which we are happy to say we have two members of the public here to speak to us. And you got here first, so if you would introduce yourself and step up to the microphone, please.
I'm not used to hearing my own voice, so.
This is Tanya Kowaleski, right?
Yes, Kowaleski.
Fire away.
I have 3 minutes. I have always loved that building that's right across from Seafresh, that at 537 East Ojai Avenue. When I first moved here, it was like, oh, that would make a great studio. I'm a painter and sculptor. I just last night became a member of OSA.
Congratulations.
Thanks. But what I called the realtor about it when I saw that sign, and she said it was selling for $1.5 million. And so my first thought was, can I get 10 people together with $100,000 each and get it to be some sort of gallery and public sculpture display, or, you know, sculpture garden? And, you know, I thought, oh, can you imagine getting 15 people to agree on something? And so I was having, you know, second thoughts about pursuing it. And then I was talking with Sonny right in my backyard. And I said, do you know anybody who might be interested in buying that so that the City of Ojai could have another art center? And she was thinking, and she said a few names of people who might be interested in something like that happening. But then she said, why don't you go to the Ojai Arts Council meeting? And so here I am. So if you have any suggestions, instead of it turning into, there were always rumors it was going to be a brewery, and the woman who bought it, I talked to the realtor, she said the woman who finally bought it was going to have it be a, it's not a convention center, but it's a place where, a retreat type place where people can go and what is the word for that?
Aging. Commune.
She had spent $100,000 on architect to make the plans, and it was all passed or okayed by the city or something. And then she got a job in Palo Alto that was a dynamite job and put the property up for sale. So I thought, instead of letting it go, isn't there some way the City of Ojai could invest its resources, whether financial or referring? Is my 3 minutes up?
No.
Oh, to have that stay in the community. Ojai, what draws so many people here, including myself, not only how beautiful it is and what paradise it is, but it's such an art community. So we have a museum, but it could be larger. I mean, there's all sorts of possibilities of what it could be, so I just wanted to throw that out there instead of just letting it pass.
I think it would be a wonderful project for OSA to engage in.
Okay.
because I don't mean to sound flippant, because they are, after all, a organized body of artists who represent strongly the arts in this community. But certainly the Arts Commission, I think, would endorse any effort like that.
And so, as the Arts Commission, do you have any secret body of donors that like to see the arts?
All I can say is that the city is very generous to us in terms of our budget, which, as I recall, was a total of $35,000 for this year.
Nice.
So
yeah,
we are not in any way in a position to make bids for a building.
Right. I didn't expect that. I just thought maybe, you know, that just getting the word out puts the idea out into the atmosphere, and word can travel and maybe something can happen.
Right.
Okay.
Well, thanks for bringing it to us.
Okay,
good
thank
idea.
You.
Facebook.
Oh, can I say one thing?
Please,
too?
Yes.
I do know a lot of background on that. I'm not sure what the status is at this current time. I knew somebody that had tried to buy it before, and the property owner they were dealing with had a lot of issues with the city, and that's why most of it fell through. It was not, nothing was approved at that point. I don't know what the current history is, and that was like a year and a half ago or 2 years ago. They ended up building a brewery in Ventura, but the history on that property has been a long time coming, so it will be interesting to see what happens.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome to Ojai.
Thank you. I've been here for 5 years, but I was working in L.A., so now
you're here.
Now I'm here full time.
Good. Okay, our next speaker is someone who is entirely familiar to us, former longtime member of the commission.
This is paraphernalia, yes. This is a, we're really actively trying to raise funds for scholarships. And Jeffrey Kressel and...
Ms. Stinsmuehl and Amond, I apologize. If you wouldn't mind speaking into the microphones
For
the record, for the minutes.
Okay.
Thank you so much. We just want to make sure we get it all. Thank you.
Yes, so the little card is a fundraising card. And we use the funds mostly for scholarships. And we have raised our... I'm sorry, I'm Susan Stinsmuehl and Amond... I live at 291 Avenida del Recreo in the unincorporated area. I used to be on the Arts Commission for way too long. No, for a long time. And I'm here tonight on behalf. I'm now the co-chair with Carol Shaw Sutton of the Scholarship Committee. This is a new event. Richard Franklin was somebody that was the head of it for a long time. So I'm kind of new to this role, but I'm here for two reasons, surrounding the scholarship committee and its events and efforts. First of all, I want to thank the Arts Commission for your generous support of the student scholarship winners from Ojai and Ventura County. You've done that for a number of years, and I'm not sure how many years. Roger, do you know?
Mentors, you mean?
I think it's been about 3 years.
Yes. Well, what you've done so generously is you've allowed us to have a reception here for the scholarship winners and their parents and friends. And then you also receive artwork, their artwork, and hang a show honoring their work. Some of them, you know, these are students in high school and college, some of them showing perhaps for the first time in a public space. So It's really a meaningful experience to see them here, and it's the auspicious nature of our beautiful City Hall. And so, but it's not gone unnoticed that that the amount of work that goes into receiving us for the reception and for receiving the art and hanging the art, and then being around perhaps when it comes down, when the students pick it up. And we'll be more helpful this year. I don't know how helpful we've been in the past, but I'm just hoping that you'll do this again. It's a wonderful thing to do for students and for the city. And we'd especially like to target Nordoff and children who are, or young adults who are going to college from our area, but it is open to Ventura County. but we, I just went to a Nordhoff scholarship fair the other night, which was sweet, you know, just all these young folk heading off to their futures, but we're advocating for the artists. So I have a rough schedule of what I've sketched out, but I haven't. It's not based on talking with you. So I'm Roger. Are you still head of that committee, or was it Heather who was the
head
of that?
It was Heather, right?
Okay, so we.
It's going to be Michael, I think.
Pardon?
I'm not sure who it will be. We're going to be establishing that. I think at this point it would be appropriate for you to just give us that rough schedule, and then we'll put this all on our February agenda. I know it's something that we've supported very strongly in the past, but I think for us to take action on it, we'll have to do it as a February agenda item. Is that soon enough for you?
Well, we're already advertising for the scholarship with a schedule, and it says that we... At the end of May, students deliver artwork to Ojai City Hall, and reception and opening of the exhibition on June 3rd, reception and awards ceremony. Now, it doesn't have to, I say, in we've got this on our website. It doesn't say that we're still massaging dates and all of that. So I just had to say something.
Sure. So, Linda, you have a question?
I have a question. Now, you're not talking about the mentorships between... No. You're talking about the scholarship.
Yeah,
I was confused.
Scholarships,
so,
yeah.
Yes, sorry.
Just wanted
no,
to
the
make
mentorship
sure.
is your program, right. Although yeah, a lot yeah. of OSA artists become part of... Become mentors,
yeah.
which is great. It's so symbiotic.
Yeah.
But no, this is our scholarship
yeah.
program. And we have over $10,000 to give this year. We're aiming for 15. So when a student gets $2,000, that's huge.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I think it's safe to say that this is a program we've been happy to participate in.
I apologize. We're getting a little dangerously close to making decisions and deliberating on topics that aren't on the agenda.
Right. That's why I'm saying it will be on the February agenda. I'm just trying to smooth the way.
I understand how... You're volunteering your time and efforts, and you've lost somebody, and you're going to get somebody, and it's all up in the air. Volunteerism fosters unknown sometimes, so I truly appreciate on behalf of all of us what you do.
Linda, you have a question?
I have another thing. If you're done with that portion, I wanted to ask you about a couple other events I hear through a little birdie are happening. I would like you to announce them if they're happening. I talked to Brian today, and he said you are going on with the OSA Open Studio Tours again
They're called the OSA, Ojai Studio Artists Mini Tours, and I have the schedule for that so that you could put that maybe on your master calendar.
I put it on there today, but I would like a copy of all the, because I talked to Brian, I just
yes,
happened to
Yes, this has
into
all
it.
The people, and the mini tours are once a month, and they're like six artists in different neighborhoods of the city. They're free, and then you can just go and kind of, it's very informal kind of wonderful. A lot of artists go see other artists, so you can bump into.
And then aren't you doing something at the church or the synagogue in Miners Oaks?
Well, it's something that the Arts Commission first started, which was the Arts Ojai Outreach, your program,
mm-hmm.
and Barbara Hirsch, in fact, had thought the Art 21 films that are now going to, they've shifted over to OSA, and Pamela Grau is sort of in charge of that with Barbara, and this next Monday is the first one, and it's Art 21, and it features really contemporary artists around the world. In this case, I think it's the U.S., and it's an hour-long series. It's a award winnings, and I think it's at 7:15 at the Jewish Community of Ojai. And while you're there, you can see my stained glass windows that I did that are now installed at the
community,
the Jewish Community of Ojai. So yeah, there's great things happening. So I'll give you the schedule, the tentative schedule, and I was trying to work around the music festival, and when kids get out of school, and Memorial Day weekend. So those are factors in all of that.
And if you can get us the dates ahead on the other things, I can put them in the calendars too. So
The Art 21?
Whatever else you have coming up with the scholarships, any of those events.
Oh, yeah.
Events.
No, The scholarships, yeah, that's here.
Okay, but I mean, for the future, if you can have Pam send me any of those other dates.
Okay.
I have those now, but okay. It really helps, so.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, good. We're getting more organized.
I would just like to say that Richard Franklin did really a fantastic job working with us, and we really appreciated how organized he was, and I'm sure you're going to carry on that tradition, and I'm sure we'll look forward to working with you.
After we discuss it and make a decision formally. Yes.
And the schedule?
We'll give that to Linda. To Linda.
Sorry.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Susan.
Okay, we have a fair number of things to consider. We're going to move on now to a discussion of the 2017 calendar. And what I would like to suggest to the commission is that we discuss it in general terms first and briefly, and then Linda and I will sit down with the schedule as it currently stands and flesh it out, and then we will circulate it from there. Is that everybody comfortable with that? Okay. Let's wait for Christine to get back.
Here I am.
Okay. We're moving on now to a discussion of the calendar. And what I suggested in your absence was that we have some discussion of it now briefly. And then Linda and I will take any and all comments into consideration and flesh it out. And we will then have a calendar for the year. One of the things that comes to my mind immediately is that I want to jump all of the dates relating to the Artist Mentor Program as far forward as possible. I've already begun to speak to artists in the community about applying for the program. I would very much like to have the artists in place by the end of February so that we can then solicit students on the basis of who the artists are going to be and get those determinations made before the students' spring break, because our experience in the past has been that if they have to make decisions after spring break, they are so tied up with final exams and college applications and family reunions and heaven knows what, that we don't get a very good response. So that's the one thing that I think is really important in terms of our calendar for the year. Other comments or thoughts?
I did notice that there is no press release on the grants on the calendar, and that should be in January.
Oh. The press release for grants awarded should be in January, because that's always finalized.
Okay, I think that's something that we should go through the entire calendar when we sit down and work out exactly when the press releases need to be.
May I suggest?
Yes.
This is a meeting calendar, which is great for like people like me who put together the agendas. I think that it might be a good step for the Arts Commission to make a master calendar of all of the different functions that happen outside of regular meetings.
That's what this kind of is.
Yeah, I think that's exactly the direction we're moving in.
So we're moving this away from being a meeting calendar into being a commission and committee master calendar.
We'll make it a master calendar, and then from that we can extract the meeting calendar. Okay?
Thank you.
Other comments?
Well, on your mentor program timeline, you probably want to flip June and April, don't you?
Mentor program begins.
Well, yeah. No, it begins in June when the kids are out of school.
Well, it says June, and then after that, April. Students are selected June Mentor First Program. I think just noting that they seem to be in not in order.
Where are we looking?
Mentor Program Timeline, it's the third page.
Third page? There's only two pages.
I've only got two pages, number one.
Commissioner Golden's looking at a separate item. She's looking at the mentorship timeline.
I don't have a copy of that.
Commissioner Golden, we're all looking at the master calendar for the meeting schedules. That's a separate item.
Yes, in the third page after that.
It's a separate item.
That's a separate item, and we don't have that in front of us. We're talking about the master calendar.
We're just looking at the two-page master calendar for 2017.
Oh, see, mine are all stapled together. I thought it was all one thing.
No, just the one. We'll develop the mentor program out of the master calendar.
All right, so you don't care about the error on there. Neither do I.
No, we'll change it. We'll change it.
When you're moving.
I'm just trying to be helpful.
You're moving.
And you
March.
Are.
Yeah. He's moving. I think, Christine, he wants to move the March begin process up to January, right?
Correct.
So the first item under March 16th would be under January 19th begin process. And what else did you have?
And then what do you move the Homestead Harvest?
We'll move that up to February.
Which one? Host?
The end of February.
Where is it at now?
Anyway, I don't think we need to get into the nitty-gritty of the details of that particular program here. What I think would be more efficient would be for us to take any general comments from the commission now, and then Linda and Amber and I will sit down and thrash out the details, and we'll circulate that before the February meeting, so that it can then be on the agenda for the February meeting to approve.
And if I may, I apologize for the confusion. That's entirely on me. There's actually two different items.
Right.
So the 2017 calendar is what we're discussing now, and what Commissioner Golden was discussing was actually item B, the 2017 program timeline. And hers was stapled out of order, so I apologize for the confusion. They should have been labeled better.
Sorry about that.
That's okay. So we're all on the same page now?
I think so.
Okay. Can we move on to the next agenda item? The timeline is the next agenda item, in fact. And
I do have something to say. I'm forgetting to turn this on. In the past, we've always included on here the City Gallery calendar when a new artist would be in. So depending on your decision in response to the offering to get City Gallery going again, that should be added.
Excellent. Yeah, and the museum
output
should be on it as well.
I also would suggest that if it's possible, it would be nice if we knew when the joint meetings were and could put that on there, especially if it's not just a meeting calendar.
Yeah.
You think?
Good idea.
All right.
Yeah, that's a little harder because that's pretty much at the discretion of the city council.
Yeah, but we might know a month.
Their schedules are sort of cockamamie, so.
But we might know a month. We could just put it like that's the month.
Yeah.
But we have an opportunity to text or email you as we take a closer look at this.
Please do.
Okay. Thank you, Michael. Thank you, Linda.
I don't know if I have that.
I don't have that.
Well, again, given the fact that we're going to sit down and thrash that out, we can work that out and make that a part of everything that's to be approved then at the February meeting. Is everybody comfortable with that?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Okay. All right, let's move on to the City Gallery Committee. And that is?
Roger, it's you and I, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
Right now.
Basically, since we last met, we put up a new show. And it's a combination. It actually grew out of the combining the museum collection with the municipal collection. And so now we have examples of both things from the museum as well as the city collection. And we've kind of mixed them as things that we thought would go together and to also get more exposure for, like there are some things that haven't really been seen before anywhere, and we have those introduced.
And we need to publicize that, and Christine is not here, but I spoke with her today and forewarned her that the day she gets back from Washington, D.C., she and I are going to be talking about all the news releases and website stuff that needs to be done. So I think it'd be appropriate to have a news release to highlight what you just said, that there are a lot of work that hasn't been seen, and that it's a part of this whole initiative to work together with the museum.
Can I add that Roger is in doing a great job photographing everything nicely, professionally, so that we'll have really nice things to put in our PR from now on. He's already, you took all the photos from the joint show that we have, and it's just wonderful that we have somebody that's volunteering their time to do that. So I have to say kudos.
Yes, our thanks again to Roger. Okay, anything else on the City Gallery Committee? I think obviously this will be a subject of discussion in our next meeting vis-a-vis what Susan Amend presented this evening.
Yeah, and I think on that we really need to develop what kind of shows we want to have, and I don't think we've been as active as we have in the past. And so I think whoever is going to be in charge of that really has an opportunity to make something of this.
I think that's a very good idea, especially with the coordination with the museum, to try and work out a, if you will, a whole year's pattern
right.
for what shows are going to be. I mean,
yeah.
It occurs to me, for example, it could just be a show of photographs, because we have some spectacular mm-hmm. photographs in the collection.
Right, and also we tend to coordinate with like the OSA show at the museum,
yes.
and we
yes.
generally have the scholarship setting up at the same time, so
right.
It's really an outreach to other art groups here to make it work.
Right, right. All right. Public relations is the next subject, so we've already hit upon a couple of things that are going to need the attention of the Public Relations Committee, one of which is updating the Arts Ojai website with the mentor and student applications updated so that they're for 2017. And I want to relook at the copy for that, so I'll be working with Christine on that. And then this current show needs to be publicized. Are there any other items that members of the Commission feels we need to give some attention to in PR? Linda?
Grants definitely have to go out. I mean, they're being dispersed now, right?
Yes.
The grants? Yeah, so we definitely need a grant announcement.
So we need a release, a news release on the grants.
Yeah. I mean, Christine doesn't have to do any. All that will help.
Okay. Okay, anything else? And we just talked about the disbursement status, so those are going out?
So,
Or have gone out?
So they've been requested and the letters have been generated. However, we need W-9s from the grant recipients, which I don't remember having required in the past. However, our finance department is asking for them now, so I'll get in contact with the recipients to get that paperwork.
Okay, thank you.
Today from one person wondering what's happening because they hadn't gotten any information. I did send letters out saying that the Arts Commission had recommended them, but it was up to the City Council to do it. And my understanding from Amber is that the City Council did accept our recommendations for that. So
so it's in the works, and it's something that I think we need to be conscious of when we make awards. Be they grants or mentorship appointments and so on, we need to forewarn people that the financial wheels of the city grind exceeding fine and exceeding slow. And this is a consequence of that,
everything
I think.
Everything has to be...
It all has to go through the proper channels and be processed, and people need to be reminded of that.
I have a question. Our last meeting, we kind of left it. Did we decide about the grants as far as that money we didn't spend? Did we spend all of it? What ended up happening with that? Because I know it wasn't totally decided. You were going to ask for some clarification. I wish we had minutes to go back over.
When the commission chooses what they would like to do with those additional, with the funds that were not spent out of the grants fund, they will take the request to the City Council to spend it elsewhere.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
So that was all firmed up because we weren't sure last meeting.
Okay. So would you make a note, Amber, to be sure that on the agenda for the next meeting, is a discussion of any and all unspent funds, such as those for the grant committee, so that we can make decisions on where we want to reallocate that and then transmit the request to the council. Okay, the awards committee is now confronting the fact that we're moving towards the Lifetime Achievement Award process, which typically is decided in March. And I think what we need to do again, and Amber, I'm afraid this falls on you, is to circulate once more that list that we circulated at the end of last year of potential nominees for that position. And then I also would like to ask the commission members to forward to me and to Amber, once she has sent you that list, any other names that you would like us to consider, so that at our February meeting, we can, as an agenda item, discuss all the various nominees, and we are forced to do this in public, narrow it down, I think, at that meeting to perhaps 10, and that will give us then a month to evaluate those highlighted possible nominees, and then at our March meeting, as an action item, will be the actual decision on who the awardee is. Does that work for everybody? Linda?
It does for me. I think it would be helpful if everyone looks. I think the website's current on that, isn't it?
On who the previous awardees were, yes, I believe
and
so.
And what the descriptions are of both the two. There's a Hope Frazier and there's a Lifetime, just so everybody's clear about the difference between the two.
Very good idea. Yeah, very good idea.
That was it.
Okay. Now we can move on to something that normally we don't have anything to talk about, but I think we do this time, public art. That's a joke. That's a joke, Christine. Nope. That's a joke.
That was a joke from my good friend Michael. Well, here we go.
Well, let me preface this by saying that this is one of our strongest and most active programs, and it's a consequence as much as anything else of the changing economic circumstances. That there's a lot of building going on. As a result, there's money flowing into public art and projects emerging. And Christine and the Public Art Committee have worked very hard on this, and the results show. Such things as the playground, such things as the artwork at the Ojai Valley Inn are all contributions to the scene here in Ojai. So before we start, thanks to Christine.
Well, thank you. I'm getting too much credit here, but thank you. I appreciate it. I never think I'm working hard enough. Well, I have several items, and they're all kind of fast. Really, just a nod to what's going on, so that the rest of you who are not on the Public Arts Committee have some idea of things that we cannot email back and forth because of the Brown Act. So, just FYI, that the Public Art Committee, which is Roger, Michael, and myself, are going to be meeting, we hope, fairly soon with Amber and possibly also with Kathleen Wald. And we'll be going through, and oh, we've invited Susan Stinsmulen, amen, to meet with us, and she's agreed, I hope she will come, to go through and take a look at areas of the ordinance where we found snags, or a lot of times just, well, what did they mean when they wrote that? What was the real intent? So that's going to happen, we hope.
That will happen dependent on direction from council.
Gone to council yet.
That goes to council at the joint meeting that you are having on Tuesday.
Oh, terrific. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this should be a joint meeting thing then.
Yes, in order for any commission to look at policy and to look at the municipal code, they need to receive direction from council, and as we have a joint meeting on the 24th with them, it's on the
agenda. So we can ask at that time for them, and then they can approve it at that time? Fabulous. Okay, I wasn't sure whether it had to go to a regular meeting. Okay, also we'll be meeting soon. Again, this is a question of just getting people together. Barbara Hirsch is now going to be the person sitting on CAPA. With us, and we're going to be meeting and talking about what is going to happen with the modification to the art wall that is part of the Libby Park Public Art Project. And also we want to, Doug Lochner will be invited to that meeting, and we want to also talk to him about his vision and how he anticipates going forward with covering the lizard with the pennies. And there are just a lot of questions. If any of you have any questions about any of this, you can email those questions to any one of the three of us or to Chester on Planning Commission. No, just to us.
John Merck is the representative.
Is John now, though?
John was always, it was the Chester.
Somebody told me it was Chester.
It was Chester has the alternate for a week.
Okay, so now it's John.
M-I-R-K.
John Merck is now, okay. But you probably want to send your questions to us, or you could send them to Barbara Hirsch, although I really have to let Barbara Hirsch know that she's coming to a CAPA meeting first, so so that's going
to
happen.
Pointing out, if I may, just to add to this, is that Susan Stinsmuller-Amond was one of the architects of the public art code and the ordinance, working on that, and Barbara Hirsch as well.
That's right.
For years. So even though they are no longer members of the Arts Commission, to have them engaged in this work is really important because they've got the background, the knowledge, the experience to right. reinforce what is being done.
Right. Another meeting that is informal is a meeting that we're going to request Michael and I to go visit Topa Mountain Winery and take a look at the what's going on with the fountain being turned off over there. Maybe it's turned on again, I don't know, but we need to be active in and make sure that they understand that running the fountain is part of the deal that they made when they chose to do a fountain as their public art piece. And if there's a problem with it, it needs to be fixed, not just turned off. So we'll be meeting with them. I'm sure we can handle it at that level. There has been communication with Trimpin that's come from city. And this is the ongoing issue with Trimpin not sounding at all. I mean, people just don't even know it's a sound arch. And city has been really wonderful. Amber has sent a wonderful letter to Mr. Trimpin asking for his input. And we'll keep you up to date on that as that progresses. And hopefully we will hear back from him so we know what to do. We have a problem ongoing there with vandalism of the mechanism that times the arch being on and off. So we've got to figure it out. We are working, and a member of our public art committee is in charge of this, making sure that every public art piece that we have has a plaque. So, for example, the Topa Mountain Winery fountain does not have a plaque. And there's one missing by the Matilaha Poppy Fountain in the Arcade Plaza. So we're in the process of finding out which ones are missing, and then we'll want to use our public art budget to have those made and have those installed. So that's something else outstanding.
And Amber has pursued that, and we now know who made the plaques, and we have
great
examples of the font that was used, so we can just work with that company again and have consistency across
the board.
Was
it Aswell?
It's Ventura of something or other. I forget. I've got
it. It's likely Ventura Trophy.
I'm pretty sure that was it.
Which is easy if it's Ventura. Yeah. That's wonderful. This is a question for Amber because I wasn't real sure. You put copies of the handbook here for me to pass out to everybody. You should really pull out of your three-ring binder the old developer's guide so that if we need to refer, we're all referring to the current one. There is a date on it somewhere. Well,
is it not current?
No, you know, but if you take the old one out and toss it and put this in, they've been three-hole punch for you. Now, at the request of a city council member, this was to go to city council for adoption, but you had some thoughts about that.
So it was my understanding was that it was a suggestion from a city council member, and the thing that is tricky about taking a working document like this to the city council is that once it's been adopted by the council, any modifications are required to go back to the council. And as this is something that is ever-changing as we learn how best to work with developers, it would slow down the process of efficiency with regards to relating to developers. It could potentially slow down the development of the document as we learn and grow with our developers.
So you're recommending that we essentially keep it in-house?
That's correct.
Good.
Yes.
Terrific.
Yes. I'm good. I hope we all were going to agree to that, because that reason makes such sense. Yeah. Thank you for that, Amber. And then we did not get tonight the project sheet. I'm looking at the one that we got back in November, and I don't know if there's anything new to be added to it. But if there is, I would request that you would just email it out. Yeah, just send it out, and so we can all take a look at it and see what's going on. We've got to always, all of us, whether you're on public art committee or not, to be vigilant. Like, for example, our speaker tonight, when she's talking about the property across the street from Seafresh, is across from Seafresh?
Yeah.
We need to be vigilant, pay attention to what's going on. A lot of times that information comes just simply from reading the OVN. Mm-hmm. Because if they're over the mark, then we want to immediately make sure that the developer, although we have better things in place at City, we want to make sure the developer knows how fortunate for them that they can make a mark on this city that will be remembered forever, because it's not that they're required, it's that they are honored. They get to do public art. It's a beautiful thing that they get to do. There's also talk about what's going to happen to the property, which is now the school district offices in Chaparral. I'm sure you've all heard the rumblings about that. We, too, need to keep a real close look at that. We're going to have to find out, because it's a public school, they're exempt from public art. But if they lease it to a non-public entity, does that also mean that now they have to do public art? We don't know. I don't know the answer to mm-hmm. that. We'll be finding out the answer to that. But that will be the most wonderful place to really do something, not for us to do something, but for the developer to do something incredible, because that's 7 acres right there. So there's that. We are going to be the public art committee.
I'm sorry. Apologize.
Yes, please.
One thing that I'm particularly proud of in regards to being vigilant with developers and whatnot, if you see the cover sheet on the guidelines, that's a sheet that developers who receive the handbook is required to sign upon receipt, and then it is placed in their project folder.
Good.
Isn't that great?
Good.
Isn't that great? Yep. And this was a suggestion from Kathleen and from Amber. Let's add this
terrific.
Step so we know they
Kathleen,
know.
It was Kathleen. I can't take credit.
and that's a wonderful segue to the outstanding money that needs to be deposited from the Ojai Valley Athletic Club project into the Public Art Fund. And I believe that is now moving forward. We're a little more optimistic about that, if I understood your email, Amber.
Would you like a quick update?
Oh, sure.
The project at the athletic club has been slightly stalled, as there's been a change in the project manager. And with this new project manager, it seems to be moving along a little more smoothly. And so we're looking forward to payment.
Yes.
Excellent.
Once the money is deposited into the public art fund, and I know we got a budget on here tonight somewhere. And I don't know if it lists the public art fund, how much is in there. So we're going to ask for that. And again, I would ask for that to be emailed out, if you would please, so that we know. But my best guesstimate off the top of my head is that there's at least $60,000 sitting in that fund right now for us. And so I've done this for the last umpteen meetings, but I'm going to do it again. I never hear back from any of you. We really need to identify a place where we can do, it's now on us and the city to do a piece of public art and to use that money. We're really obligated to do that. So if you could please, I'll get to you. If you could, absolutely. If you could start brainstorming and thinking, you have to remember that we cannot do a piece of public art on private development, which is why we want private development to do it. We're not That's, we don't go now into a private place and say, oh, well, you didn't do it, we'll do it for you. Doesn't work that way. So it has to be public land or a public venue or something that's owned by other than private development.
It can't be, that was my question. I was going to ask you if we could, as part of our public art, we've been talking about murals forever, mm-hmm. if we could do an RFP for a mural. And that means it would have to be on a city-owned building, or is that correct?
It is, I think. But there's some maneuverability in all of this. Like, for example, now it's 4 or 5 years ago, talked to Khaled about whether or not he would permit mm-hmm. the Arts Commission to do a worldwide request for proposal for a mural on the side of the building. And he was in favor of it. As long as it doesn't cost me any money, I will give you the spot. So I think that there is an opportunity there. However, as that was unfolding those many years ago, the question came up as to whether or not, in order to do a mural, we would have to have a mural ordinance. If it turns out, and Amber, would you find that, and Mr. McCleary at the time was the liaison and had brought that up in one of the conversations we were having. If that's true, then the Public Art Committee will be working on a mural ordinance with the city in order to push that forward. It may be, and I want to preface this, I'm kind of going a little over here now and say, no matter what we do, it will be controversial. That is the nature of public art. So we might have to like really say, you know, that is the spot to do it, and we are going to like be strong and work through this in a way that the community will be supportive of a mural going up there. Or there may be another spot that I haven't thought of.
And I think it would be useful if we could get an opinion from the city attorney whether we can use public funds from our public art fund to install a public art piece, be it a mural or a statue or whatever, a trimpin piece, mm-hmm. on private property.
Yeah, that's.
I think that's a question we need to have answered. Otherwise, we are limited to public property that we can spend.
Very limited. And then there's a limited amount of public property.
Well, there's.
Right now.
Yeah. Yeah,
there really is, because you know, you've got your Arcade Plaza. It's got the art in there. You've got Libby Park. It's really kind of art-packed right now because we have to be aware of the crowds that are there. We can't be filling it up with public art. So where are these spots?
Sarzotti Park comes to mind immediately.
Sarzotti Park comes to mind.
Parking lots, some of the parking lots the city owns. We could do some. One of them already has. We have the wheel over at the
Are you on?
Yes, she is.
But the other parking lot behind the arcade, there isn't anything in there. So that might be an opportunity. But we can
if you're
ideas to explore.
Yeah.
You know, running around town and you get an idea and it's like, whoa, that would be the spot. Just please make a note of it.
I'd also like to urge anyone in our vast listening audience to come forward with suggestions if you have them. Anybody who's watching the TV version of this meeting, if you have any ideas or thoughts about where public art could be placed or what sort of public art would be of interest, please contact us or come to one of our meetings and talk to us.
Yes.
Or
and,
both, yes.
You know, we have this space right out here, right outside our door here, where we put the Peace Pole in a couple of years ago. And we always talked about, could that be a sculpture garden? Yeah. Well, there is a gentleman here in town who would love to volunteer his time to create a Japanese garden. There is, I understand, a foundation here in Ojai that's just moved in that is interested in doing a sculpture garden. And I would love to get these two people together. So I think there are possibilities out there. Could be
There's
very exciting.
Yep.
Could I ask you one more question?
Sure.
The other thing, and this is kind of, I don't know if this would be under commissioner comments. Maybe I should wait till commission comments.
As you wish.
I'll wait till commission comments.
All right, and then the last thing for me is just to, again, FYI, to let you know that Roger and Michael and I are going to format a letter that will go to City Manager McCleary and Mayor Johnny Johnson and, of course, Amber first and foremost, with a recommendation of what needs to be done and what our position is on the Doug Lochner Reflections of Ojai at Bryan Street. Roger and Michael and I met just the other day at Bryan Street so we could really, really examine it. And this is, I have to just say that Roger's expertise and what he is able to see looking at the artwork, he identified that there really are two issues. There's the issue of the damage that was caused by the sandblasting, which we have held the owner responsible for. But Roger's expert eyes also see that there is damage simply done from the positioning of a few of those panels that is caused by morning sun. So it's from weathering, which is a whole other thing going on. So we've decided to put our thoughts together and come up with a recommendation and send that off to city, and that's in the process as well. So if any of you have a chance and you're over there, it's kind of hard to find this little
Bryant Circle, right?
Well, everybody thinks it's Bryant Circle, and you can go around Bryant Circle in a circle for a while. But it's actually, if you can find the tennis courts that are off to the back of the athletic club for the kids, the ones to the back going out on Fulton, it's right there. It's literally adjacent to those tennis courts. I'd love it if you have a chance to go over and look at it and then just email any comment that you have on it. Can we do that? Is that against Brown if they tell me what they think?
As long as the communication is one direction to you and not from you to anybody else.
Okay, so you can just directly let me know what you think. So we have a couple of ideas about it.
And I would, as the committees often meet, not at a commission meeting, if you receive opinions regarding the piece from more than one commissioner, that the committee meeting would probably, it would be behoove you to have it be a public conversation.
Okay, and so not to share any of that, but to bring it back to the
right, because that's a lot of commissioners in private.
Yeah. Oh, I think
all
that's
right.
It.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's exciting. It's major work that's making an impact. So we'll move on to art acquisitions, and this is Linda Harmon's bailiwick.
Yes. Right now, I only have one other person on my committee, which is Bobby. I'm waiting for the other one, which brings me to my question. How close are we to getting another commission meeting person?
It's on the agenda under staff reports.
Oh, okay. Well, that's basically what I wanted to ask under that. And besides that, we have not moved ahead because I was waiting for my other person. We have a list, so we will do that. So I don't have anything else to say further than that.
Okay. Well, then we will move on to another major project that's in the work, and this is the Education Committee's effort to create the first of what we hope is a series of books about art in Ojai. And the first one is Architecture in Ojai, and Bobby Balderman is the chair of the committee and has been working ferociously with great results. So, Bobby, it's up to you.
Okay. Well, much progress has been made since our last meeting. It started with, I went down to UCLA and actually did some research in their research library and found access to some Julia Schumann photography that we could use in the book, only to find out that I didn't even need to go to UCLA. I could just go to the Getty, and the Getty was very wonderful and helpful, and I downloaded the images for free.
Wow.
That if I had gone to UCLA, it would have cost us money. So in a way, it was worth it to go to UCLA to find that out. But to date, we actually have 11 properties that we have either images for or permission to go photograph, or that the only two that we that are kind of questionable is that Graham Dunn, who was the photographer on two of the properties, is more than happy to let us use those photographs. He feels that this might be a question for Amber, actually, to ask this, whether we ask the city attorney or who. He took the photographs. He has given us permission to use these photographs of these two properties. He is saying, well, gee, don't you think we ought to also get permission from the owner? The Fair Use Act says, and Roger, you may correct me on this, but the Fair Use Act says that if the photographer gives permission, that's all we need. We don't need the owner, but we don't want to risk anything here. Mm-hmm. Do we need to actually get the owner to say, yeah, as long as the photographer said it's okay, it's okay with me, or are we legally okay with just... You're saying no, Roger.
No, he was answering me. I was just going to say, you'd think it would be cool of the person to have their property in there, because I would think that would add to the panache of the building and the history of the building.
Well, we actually have three different owners that do not want their properties included.
Really?
Yeah. One of them is only because he said that the current photography, he's remodeled the house so much that there's nothing that they can use, you know, or for us to use. So really, two of them just don't want their properties used. But I mean, I would think that we could use, since the photographer gave us permission, we can use his photographs.
Are there exterior shots or interior?
Both. But they're old interior shots. Yeah. These are not current.
I would think.
Yeah, so Amber, I don't know.
I think we'd be on good legal ground to go ahead and use them, but I think because it is a community project to celebrate the community, we'd be unwise to run the risk of perhaps deeply offending someone.
Right, and that's what
so
I was thinking.
So I think we should get the... Well, Roger, you have expertise in this area. What do you think?
Well, we have the similar problem with the museum in that we like have our current show, and we've found that people have mixed feelings about having it shown, and particularly if the address is known, where you could have people like coming by to look it over.
We're not doing that. We're not.
But we found that generally historical pictures tend to have less sensitivity about it than current things do. Mm-hmm. But we have, all over the valley, we've run across problems of, you know, like wanting to get good pictures of the Pierpont cottages and things like that, and we haven't been able to do it, so.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
I was just gonna say, I think it's a public historic document, and if it's taken from a public right-of-way, and we've got the permission of the photographer, I think we're fine. And I wouldn't have a problem with
it. I can check with the city attorney. To my knowledge, if a photograph is taken from the public right-of-way and doesn't feature any faces, that it is legal to use the photograph.
That's what I thought.
And then to be just a little bit of a stickler and get off that point for a moment, is this something that the Arts Commission isn't intending to sell?
Yes.
Yes.
And if it
There's
is,
it, yeah.
and if it is, you have to get a film permit.
Film permit?
No. First of all.
Still photography, if it's used for commercial use, which is something that you're selling,
it's very
requires
different.
A permit. Okay.
It's very different. But the one thing, if you don't mind my continuing here, I guess I'm gloating a little bit because I feel so good about all these people cooperating. Mm-hmm. But I got a call today, for example, from the general manager of the Byron Katie, the Works, and that building. And they are very excited about being part of this and can't wait for us to schedule something to come over and photograph. So that is the Crotona. The general manager of Crotona is very excited about us doing it. He is right now looking for photos to see if he can find any archival photos for us. One thing that we are finding is that a lot of these archival photos are black and white. They are not color. But I actually think it's going to add some depth to the
Absolutely.
Book. Absolutely. I don't think that's a problem. But it's been a very interesting experience talking to people in the community about this project and snooping. And one of the things I just want to share with you that I found out, that it's as easy as calling up the assessor's office in Ventura County and saying, who owns this property and what is their address? How can I get a hold of them? And they give you that information. And so I have some of the addresses. One of them is in New York. It's an entity in New York that owns one of the houses in Ojai. But the Pierpont Gin House is one of the ones that it's a mystery. We are not finding images of it. We're not finding an owner of it. Mm-hmm. It's kind of, it may not be included. Pardon?
Where is that at?
I don't have the information with me, but I have the address. But
I'm sure you've checked with Dave.
Microphone.
Mason. You've checked with Dave Mason already on?
Oh yeah. Yeah. No. We've done. Trust me, we've exhausted resources in Ojai. That's why I ended up with the Getty and UCLA and going even beyond that to get images.
Did you talk to Rose Boggs too?
Who?
Rose Boggs. She knows so much about Ojai. She's an amazing
Linda.
Microphone, Linda.
Oh. Rose Bach. She's on the Historic Commission.
Okay, well, I can write
she's
her name
really,
down and talk to her.
But
Craig Walker.
She's lived her whole life.
Craig Walker has been amazing, too, and he's been very helpful. So
and
I just
Craig
feel
is,
good.
Is actually, as you probably all remember, is one who's actually writing the text. And then Mark Lewis is going to be the editor, so this is, in a real sense, a joint project of the museum and the Arts Commission, which
True.
Is, again, a very nice addition to our initiative in that direction.
And I do want to add that Craig is starting to write in a few weeks, which is part of the reason I have been working so hard on getting this together, because he can't write if he doesn't know which properties are included. So, but as I said, we have about 10 or 11 that are confirmed, and I have two others that I'm feeling very confident about. I'm just waiting for their answer. So that's 13, and our goal was to try to get 10 to 15. So, you know, we're in good shape, and I feel really good about
Yay.
That it's moving along. And
Yeah.
So it's great.
Terrific. We're on target with that. Okay, we can move now to the staff liaison report, if you would, please, Amber.
So just a couple of things. The budget, I captured only the expenditures from the funds that have actually had funds spent out of them. So the arts grant and the artist mentorship program, the other funds remain whole as they appear on the adopted budget page. The arts grant fund has a remaining $730 in it, and the artist student mentorship program is a little bit deceiving.
They're very small.
As
where are we, Amber?
We're on the general ledger for the artist student mentor program.
Is that this? Oh, the general ledger. That's the art grants.
Yeah.
There. There's a student mentor. I'm sorry.
So this fund is a little bit tricky because of the mentor program did not play out as it has traditionally done in the past. And so I'll have a better update for you in February when the closure of the 2016 program is more solid and
good.
Yeah.
Christine?
Oh, are you done, Amber?
I was done with the budget portion.
All right, well, keep going. I can wait until she's
keep going.
On the vacancies, as of right now, we have one official vacancy. we have one official vacancy. And so our admin personnel in the city manager's office is working to schedule that with the mayor and his selection of a council member and the chairs. I'm still working on the issue that you brought up, Commissioner Addison, via email with the city manager, having a hard time getting him pegged down. One of the things that we're struggling with right now in our department, and we're very excited to have a light at the end of the tunnel, is that we've had a temporary person filling in the records manager position and also serving human resources on a part-time basis, and she's run out of hours on her contract, and so all of the records manager duties have fallen back into the city manager's office, and so it's been a bit of a balancing act. So, but the light is near as our new records manager, her name is Gail, is scheduled to begin on Monday.
Oh, will we have minutes?
Yes.
So we ask that all staff and commissioners and council members bear with us while she gets situated. I understand, and the city manager understands, the need to have minutes from the commission meetings. We haven't had a full-time records manager for pretty much a full year at this point, and so it's going to be a little bit of just getting everything, all the cats herded and wrangled, and things moving smoothly.
I have to be a little bit more. Do you have a time frame for when we are going to get minutes, and are we going to get our backlog minutes also?
So the backlog minutes will come at the same time as your new ones are coming in. I don't want to make a promise that I can't keep, as I'm not in the position and I haven't actually spoken with her and sat down at her desk with her to see what her workload's going to be like.
So you don't know if it's going to be months or?
I don't want to make a promise I can't keep.
Christine?
I would just add to that. If in doubt, you can always go to the internet and you can watch meeting and see what happened there. So at least we have that record to fall back on.
Yeah.
My question wasn't about the budget. It was another question for Michael, so that's why I didn't want to interrupt you.
Does anybody need any additional information on the vacancies fulfillment?
I'd kind of like to know, you said you haven't scheduled the meeting yet?
So the interviews that our admin is working to have them scheduled either the last week in January or the first week in February so that they can be, the commissioners can be comfortably selected so that they can be appointed for the first meeting in February by the city council. And then they can meet with the chair and get situated for the February meeting so that we can assign them to committees and move everything forward in 2017.
Okay, thank you.
February. Okay.
Okay, now may I?
Yes, okay. We will move so now to our, commissioner two, comments.
Two things. Did I miss, which is possible, a report on where we are with this year's mentor program in terms of giving out awards, like who completed, and I mean, because did I miss that? Because I really wanted some information. Or is that going to happen in February?
We had three pairs complete the work, and I contacted them to see if there was a possibility of having a reception this evening. Only one of the artists responded, and also one of the other students is already away at college.
Wow.
So it seemed really unlikely that we could do anything significant. What I did say to those who were involved is that we would like to include their work in the reception that we will have in the fall of 2017.
Okay.
So that at that time, we will display the work of the three students who completed the program in 16, plus the students who complete the work in 17. I've also transmitted the address and contact information to Amber in terms of the payments to all of those involved so that they can then get their checks, which is the scholarships for the three students and the completion of the stipend for the three artists.
And what is the, what criteria are we using to know that those students actually completed the requirements of the program at this point?
Well, the requirements of the program was that they complete 50 hours of work with the mentor, and we know
and
that that's
we,
happened.
We do know that that did happen, but not in all cases.
No, two of the five simply dropped by the wayside.
So we have three that completed.
So we have three that completed.
And we have some evidence of that from the...
Yeah.
Okay, all right, just wasn't real sure on that.
Bobby?
I'm just curious who the three are that... completed.
The three artists?
Yeah, the three artists.
Julia Zonick, a musician whose name I don't remember, a younger guy, Donald something or there, I forget, and
can't help you on this one because I don't know.
Cheryl Shaw Sutton.
What do they do?
The third is Cheryl Shaw Sutton.
Yes, Carol Shaw Sutton is the third one.
My apologies.
So those were the three.
The
I'm looking through my old emails. Give me one sec.
This is why we need minutes.
Yeah.
And the other question that I had was Are we going to talk about Tuesday's agenda?
The agenda on Tuesday is for each member of the head of each committee, which is to say you, Public Art, Roger, the Gallery Committee, Linda, the Acquisitions Committee, you, the Art Education. Christine will speak about PR and things of that order, and I will speak about the Artist Mentor Program. I'll make some opening remarks, and then we each have, let's say, 5 minutes to talk about the challenges, satisfactions, and exciting prospects and completed projects of that particular thing. I mean, it's an opportunity for us to share with the council, although the council members come to our meetings, so they have a sense, but it's an opportunity to share with them, I think, a sense of the high level of activity of this commission and what we've achieved. And I think that's equally important, because I remind you that we have for now, what, I think 3 successive years persuaded the city council to give us an ever-increasing budget.
Yes.
And I am hoping to do the same thing this year. For example, I want in this upcoming budget to include, I think we only had $2,000 in this year's budget for the education for the book. Is that right?
Plus
the stipends for the photography and the design work. But we're going to need money to support the publication of that book in our next year's budget, as well as any private fundraising that we can do.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's a way for us to structure that meeting.
Mm-hmm.
So that we each have our own area of expertise.
Are we going to, and I would assume that you would be the one to do it, talk about our position that the number of commissioners remain at 7?
Yes.
The joint meeting agenda, I actually printed one for each of you, is up there at next to Commissioner Addison, if you'd like to all take a look at it.
Here you go.
What are we looking at?
The agenda for the joint meeting on Tuesday. He's passing it around now.
Okay. Do that in February.
Oh, good.
The name of the
five-member commissions is right on there.
Yeah.
The third mentor to complete, I believe, was David Harrison.
Oh, fabulous.
Henderson, excuse me.
David, that was it. David,
yes.
Henderson.
David Henderson.
Thank you. Thank you.
Do we want to talk now about chair appointment terms, which is limited according to the handbook, because we have an opportunity to speak to council if we don't like that arrangement?
Well, that's a question for discussion, and I do want to discuss it with the council, because the handbook says a new chair will be elected. New does not necessarily mean different.
No.
And I think that's what we need to clarify with the council.
Okay.
Okay?
All right, good.
It's never, I mean, we've had, in the past, we've elected people every year, but it didn't have to be a different person every
Precisely.
Year.
Precisely. So and I just want to clarify
yeah,
that.
Yeah, okay. Because that's been the way it's been ever since I've been on here.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, continuing with commissioner comments. Commissioner,
okay.
Next.
Right.
Roger.
I'm going to have to step down from the commission starting on the 31st of this month. I'll be sending in a card or a letter explaining it. For the last 3 years, I've been kind of a caretaker with my wife, who has cancer, and she has stage 4 cancer. And I'm finding that cancer is a very unpredictable thing, and I find that my time usage and the ability to make commitments is getting very, very difficult. And the longer we go, the more I'm having to juggle. So I think it would be not good for the commission if I can't really meet the deadlines and all the exciting projects and would be slowing them down. So it's with great reluctance that I'm going to have to step down. I've really enjoyed working with all of you during it. I started on January 22nd, 2008, so it's approximately 9 years.
9 years.
Now, and right, it's a long time, but it's also an opportunity to get fresh blood in here and get new ideas, and I've heard some of the people that are being considered, and it sounds really exciting, so I'm, kudos for everybody to do it. And I'll still be around, but my time is very unpredictable right now.
Well,
but thank you all for your support.
This is heartbreaking on so many levels, Roger.
Will you come back? Maybe.
Well,
someday.
It's someday, possibly. I, you know, again, with cancer, you really don't know how long one has. And, you know, maybe you'll get a miracle and things will turn around.
Yeah.
So it's, but right now I'm having a hard time juggling all my responsibilities. So.
Well, I think just what we've been through at this evening's meeting, as we've turned to you over and over again for your expertise and your thoughtful comments and the incredible contribution you've made to this commission in terms of everything you've done to make the galleries so focused and vital and absolutely professional.
Mm-hmm.
And you're bringing that body of expertise and your willingness to do the amount of work that was involved too in hanging show after show. You know, we talk about unheralded volunteers in a community, and God knows you are one of
definitely
them, Roger.
They're there.
Thank you.
You've made an incredible contribution.
Okay. Thank you.
Can I
add some words?
Please do.
I would. Roger came on the commission just a few months. I was appointed in October of 2007, and he was appointed in January of 2008. And I don't know, it's hard for me to imagine you not being here.
Yeah.
Because I always felt like somehow we were like the two that came at the same time. And we immediately were assigned to work with each other on the City Gallery Committee. And at the time, the City Gallery Committee was a delightful little occurrence that would happen, but a little bit haphazardly, I don't think it's unfair to say. And Roger took ownership of turning City Gallery into a, you know, he had the vision for painting the inner halls. I mean, the way you wouldn't even probably know this, Amber, but the way it looked before he selected those colors, all of it, the way in which he goes about hanging with such care, with such detail, he's even invented a contraption that allows him to always hit that nail once, right at the exact spot in the wall. You know, exactly how many inches is the center of that painting up to make it best for the viewer. There's little placards that he bothered to make up, the little bio that he would write and put on the wall, paste up on the wall for each and every artist. I mean, it's just, you use the word professional, and it just has been absolutely dynamite professional.
The lighting system.
Knowing what the correct lights were to put in that gallery space. It changed everything in that hallway to have the correct lighting in there. And keeping it up to date and keeping it energy, you know, in the positive side of energy output. So I really feel like I got to know Roger. And when you met with Roger on a Saturday to put up a gallery show, you were there from the morning until pretty late in the afternoon. It was a whole day thing that Roger was willing to do every other month, in addition to the role that he picked up at the museum, hanging those shows. And I know at some point you had a number of just how many shows you hung over here at City Hall. And you looked at me and you said, do you know I've hung 30 shows? And let's rethink this. And we will have to rethink it, because without you being there, it just won't be the same thing. But aside from that, working with you on the grants committee as well, which you just sort of like kind of like took it over and made it so easy for me and Linda not to even have to do very much, because you just masterminded how to get it done, and the other committees that you and I have worked on. The thing for me that you have represented has been a way to discuss issues in that's calm, even-handed. You don't give in, you've got a point of view, but there's a kindness to you, Roger.
Here.
And you know that you've been like a mentor of kindness. I have not been a very good pupil. But then I'm a mentor of something else. But you know, I'm so appreciative of knowing you and calling you friend. I think you're just one of the most special people I've ever known. I'm going to miss you so much. Aww.
Well, I just want to say the support, particularly on the Grants Committee in the early days, we spent a lot of hours hashing out the forms and all that. So it did make it a lot easier to do it. But I really appreciate your support so much, your insights, and your...
I don't do much. I just follow in your guys' footsteps.
Yeah, but it's really good to know you have people that have your back and doing these things. So anyway, enough said. Thank you.
Well, could we add to the February agenda a formal resolution of thanks, first of all? But also, could we create a new title and make the first holder of that Commissioner Emeritus? Because the benefit of what Roger has contributed isn't going to disappear as he leaves the room. All the things that Christine has talked about and that we all know about what Roger has contributed, that's still with us.
Yeah,
and
they'll live on. They
that's
will.
An incredible gift you've given to us, Roger. Thank you. Thank you.
And I got to tell you, too, you're worried about letting us down, and you have never in this whole, I know you've been going through a lot, and the whole thing with the museum and the show and everything, you have been there 100% of the time. So I don't ever want you to think you ever did that. It's because you didn't.
Well, right.
You haven't.
Yeah, I'm just afraid that I might not be able to, and it will let you down or whatever.
Okay, well, we'll continue with commissioner comments. Linda, do you have anything to add at this point?
Now I got to think. Put my thinking cap back on. I did. Oh, the monies. When we were talking about the monies that we did not spend on the grants, and apparently there's some other monies we didn't spend that she mentioned, can we put it on the agenda to consider using part of that money to go forward to have Christine as a public art, this is just an idea, as a public art chair, and maybe Chris to help out, or the PR committee to help out, and possibly actually publish a public art guide. We had tried to do that during our museum show, and it didn't happen because we didn't have enough time and we didn't have enough hands-on skills and monies.
May I make an administrative suggestion?
Yes.
I have it on my list to place on the February agenda, a discussion of the unspent funds and where they should go. Perhaps if each commissioner has thoughts about where they'd like that they'd like to go, they could send them in to me and I could include it in the packet that will go out well before the next Arts Commission meeting.
Good idea.
Great
that way
idea.
Everybody has
Good.
Some time to ponder and then we don't get...
Okay.
Excellent.
Yeah.
These are, just so I know what you're asking for, these are ideas of how to spend that money that wasn't spent on the...
Yes.
Whatever. Can I just respond to a little bit to what Linda said?
You can. No. Try not to dance too close discussing non-agendized items.
Right. I just wanted to... I know, but I just wanted to say that is on the Public Art Committee plate, and we're thinking, waiting until the next round of public art pieces are done so that we have, there's a couple that are about to happen. We thought, let the dust settle on those before we do that map.
Good.
And because we're doing the architecture book, because we certainly want to rely on that committee. Just a thought.
Well, we can talk
without
about
a discussion.
That.
Okay. Bobby, any comments? Well, I only have one comment that I want to make in closing, and that is... as we know, tomorrow is a day that is going to initiate potentially a radical change in the nature of the body politic in America. There are already rumblings that the budgets of the National Endowment for the Arts and the National Endowment for the Humanities are going to be cut, and perhaps cut severely. And I'm sure there are other ramifications that will come into play. I think we just need to recognize that even though the climate for art in this community is extraordinarily vital and fertile, and that there is a collective consciousness in Ojai that supports the arts and believes in the arts as a part of the life of the community, the ongoing life of the community, that may not be the case elsewhere as we go forward. And there are going to be struggles that I think it's important that we recognize the arts need to be a part of that debate, that dialogue, that struggle, because art is about truth, and we need to remember that art is powerful and that art can be a voice that needs to be heard. And I think that our charge as members of this commission has never been more important than it is as we go forward. Any other comments this evening? Then the meeting is adjourned. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, Michael.
Well said, Michael.
Good meeting, everybody.